This video is going to cover topo transfer in Houdini. The dictionary definition of topo transfer is that it non-rigidly deforms a surface to match the size and shape of a different surface. In our case, we're going to take a head geometry that has clean quad topology, and we're going to project that around our head scan, which has very dense and ugly topology that's non-uniform, but we want to capture the features of that using our clean mesh. So let's jump into Houdini and have a look. I'm going to hit the tab key and drop down a file node. And I'm going to load my head scan. I'm going to hit space H. And you can see that my scan is not oriented properly. And this is probably usually going to be the case. So we can correct that by appending a transform node. So hit tab and type transform. Shift enter. And I'm going to hit enter key in the viewport, hold down control, and just snap rotate that 90 so that it's in the correct position. And now sometimes you might want to use this move centroid to origin to better position your geometry. And now I'm just going to scale that to something smaller. Leave it like this for now. Next, I'm going to hit tab and put down topo transfer. And if I hover over the inputs, you can see it needs a target geometry and a source geometry. Our scan is the target geometry, and we're going to put down our clean geometry head. So that's the template head geo. And I'm going to also template that so that I can better position my target geometry to be closer to the source geometry. So I will just move this up and position that, maybe make it a little bit smaller, like so, and just bring that closer, and I'll move it a little bit forward in the perspective, like this. We can always adjust it afterwards. And now I'm just going to turn off the template and plug this guy in. So now I'm going to hit R key to place my display flag and look on the topo transfer. And now I'm ready to place some landmarks. And what landmarks does is that it allows us to tell Houdini to pay attention to these areas that we want to kind of capture these regions. So let's start with the eyes. And we can always just keep in mind that these points are adjustable after. Now I'm going to hit the Control G key and swap between my scan data and the clean mesh. So the yellow dot is indicating that this is the active one. So now I'm going to move it closer to the point that corresponds with the scan to match the kind of similar area on the clean geometry. Like so, and then I'll hit Control G to jump back to my clean mesh. And I'm just going to quickly place these points. Control G to jump back to my scan, and we'll just move that approximately there. That was kind of a similar spot, actually. Control G again, and we're going to do the mouth. And just position that here. That's also kind of close. So now we're going to go to click on solve. And let's see what we get. We get like a fungus head. So we actually have some setting, rigid primitive actually option, that we can tell Houdini to ignore the bad shapes of our scan and use the shapes from the clean mesh. So in this dropdown, we actually have some pre-selected areas on the head of the clean geometry that we can isolate and say, like, don't project anything here. And so I'm going to do just that. Like, our ears are bad, the head is bad, the neck is also bad. So let's turn off these guys first. And my trick is to just disable the topo transfer for now and pick these guys. So ears, head, and neck. And then I'm going to enable that back. So now Houdini is going to cook with all those rigid primitives selected. So now we have better ears, and our head is looking more like a head, same for our neck, but our head is still warped because our scan data was bad because my hair was like in the way. So we can also enable manual selection of this. So I'm going to select a lot of this geometry here and close off and just isolate, just the front features to be used. So I've grabbed these and now I'm just going to deselect this area with the brush. If you're picking the faces on the back, just enable this eye icon and then you won't pick anything in the background. So now I'm going to hit the enter key and there's my head. So now if I just bring out my scan data and just put that side by side, let's turn off the grid and have a look. And so there is my topo transferred geometry from the messy scan. So if you zoom in, you can see that the mesh is super dense and not usable. But now we've captured the features here in this clean geometry. And that's topo transfer in Houdini. Thanks for watching.